Hi, Chris. Every year we plant tomatoes, yellow squash, and cucumbers. They seem to always have a limited growing season of about 3 weeks. Mm-hmm. Tomatoes and cucumbers grow the first part of July, then wilt and die after 3 weeks of bearing. I just put down 3 yards of certified compost and I tried to get indeterminate plants. Also, I'm keeping up with daily watering in the hot days, but careful not to overwater. What's up? And how can I extend the production season up to frost, if possible? Mm-hmm. Many thanks, and this is John from Columbia, South Carolina. So it's good that he's trying to grow, you know, all these different vegetables. But here's the thing, Celeste, tomatoes and cucumbers, they will wilt and die. So what do we think about the tomato first?
Okay.
And then we'll talk about
the cucumbers. Let's go with tomatoes first. Yeah. So from the picture that we saw, this looks very similar to a blight called early blight that we see on tomatoes. And it's a little confusing because it's called early blight, but it doesn't always happen early in the season.
Right,
they're
right.
like, it can't be early blight. We're in July.
Right.
And I'm like, that don't get caught up in terminology.
Exactly right.
So that's just what we call it. It is soil-borne, so like water, when it rains, it can splash up from the soil onto the bottom leaves. You'll start seeing death happening on those leaves nearest the ground on the plant, and it'll work its way up. And there's a small degree of this that's gonna happen eventually on the tomatoes. A lot of people call that firing up.
Yes,
looks like
I've
they've been
that.
Fired up from the bottom, you know. Mm-hmm. But we certainly don't want this disease to take out your plants that early in the season before they've had time to really produce a good harvest for you. So the best way to manage that is to start early before any signs of foliar damage really are showing with preventative applications of fungicide. Mm-hmm. The fungicides that are available to homeowners are not curative in nature. So once you see signs of disease on the bottom, we'll say two sets of leaves, you can count on those leaves falling off.
Yes, you can.
But when you spray it with the fungicide, you're protecting the leaves that haven't already been exposed to those fungal spores.
Good.
So that would be my best recommendation for that, is just start early with a plan to have preventative fungicide sprays on your tomatoes. Every 2 weeks,
and something
according
else,
to label.
Yeah, according to label. And something else I like to add to that, mulch.
Yes. Oh, that would be good. That's going to help prevent splash up. Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. Use a mulch of some sort.
Okay. So what about the cucumbers? What do you think about that?
The cucumbers, while it looks similar because they're both wilting and and turning yellow and drying up, that is being caused from a completely different situation. Most likely, feeding from cucumber beetles that has vectored bacterial wilt to those plants. Yep. Super common.
Yes.
Nothing that this person is doing wrong. The cucumber beetles are in our environment. I was telling you earlier, been noticing them on all kinds of plants in my garden. Not that they're hurting my flowers, but I'll be out there working around and I'm like, what's that cucumber beetle doing over here? The garden's over there.
Yeah.
definitely we need to spray to control those cucumber beetles so that we don't vector that disease and get the decline, early decline of our plants.
Yep.
Yeah, those would help.
Those would definitely help. Yeah.
So just do some scouting.
Scouting.
Right? Scout around.
Yeah.
Make sure that you know what you're looking for as far as insects go, so that you know how to time your applications.
Exactly right. And something else I'd like to mention as well, how about resistant varieties? Could there be some resistant varieties out there for your tomatoes?
Yeah, there certainly can. So when you buy a tomato plant and you look at the tag, it'll have all these strange capital letter, look like acronym abbreviations, and those stand for a variety of different diseases. So, TSWV is tomato spotted wilt virus. EB is early blight. LB, late blight. And it goes on and on. There's lots of diseases of tomatoes. But certainly check those tags and see if you know that you've been struggling with early blight, see if you can find one that has some resistance with that.
We hope you loved the video. We would love for you to ask more questions. Be sure to leave those questions in your comments.